My journey? Well, it hasn't been an easy one. From the beginning, you know, starting off, figuring out, you know, what resonated with me, what truly made me happy. At the end of the day, I think I found that true sense of purpose, where I'm supposed to be, what I'm supposed to do. And at the end of the day, what I really can tell you and what I can say is, this is me. And this is me, Sandy.
Hello!
Hey y'all, we are back at it with another recipe. What a surprise! I don't know, it's not really that much of a surprise because I love coffee and yeah, I just kind of was thinking, I can make a new recipe without, I know this is going to be a shocker, without using coffee over cardio. What a miracle. I know, I love coffee over cardio, but I was like, you know what? I want something like right now. I don't want to have to wait for a coffee. And then it dawned on me that, maybe I could try to like find something, or you know what? Scratch that. I did find something, but I'm not gonna lie to you. This chick, Kylie Ross, her cold brew recipe, my God, like it had me craving cold brew and like some sort of like cashewy, like milky type of vibe, because she uses like bomb smooth cold brew with like a cashew milk creamer, but I'm not like a creamer person. I'm more of like, okay, get like a smooth plant-based milk and just like do your little thing, you feel me? So yeah, I'll show you guys. I know the coffee's right there, but I'll show you a little later. The coffee that I ended up finding that has like the same macros as coffee over cardio. So yeah.
Okay, so you're gonna need this coffee over cardio cold brew maker, or you could just use one from Amazon or whatever. I have the filter right here. I explained in my cold brew video, you just like screw in the filter and yeah, but what we want to do first is we want to wet this little filter, that way the coffee grains could soak like properly once they're in there. Okay, we have it soaked now. okay, so I was like, you know what, like I kind of don't really feel like ordering like coffee over cardio. I know, shocker, I don't want to wait for the coffee to get there. Yeah, so I was like, like I'm trying to kind of want one right now, and like sometimes like I order a little bit too much, so I'm like, but I'm like, dang, like what coffee out there has like the same macros as coffee over cardio, which is like zero calories? And tell me why. I was at Walmart and I found this one, this coffee bean tea leaf coffee. It is 10% Kona blend, light roast, macadamia nut aroma, creamy caramel flavor, sweet finish. And it's a light roast, which is perfect for cold brew. And I was like, oh my God, that's amazing. Not only that, zero calories, zero fat, zero carbs, zero protein. I was like, oh my God, I haven't found a coffee like this in a minute, like from the store. Like, that's why I love coffee over cardio so much, because it's so macro friendly, fitness friendly, healthy, and it's just clean coffee, clean organic coffee. And honestly, this sold me. And what sold me even more when I was reading it was the fact that direct trade. So yeah, I like to buy coffees too that are fair trade or direct trade, just because they're pretty much buying like from the coffee farmers themselves or the union that the coffee farmers work at. So there's no like middleman, mystery, funny business going on there. Money is going straight to the growers and the farmers, and yeah, that's why I like getting direct trade too. So I was like, holy freaking bomb, this is awesome. And I think I might be purchasing this again if I like it, because the hints of caramel sold me.
Okay, so right here what I'm doing is I'm opening the coffee blends. taking a minute to open it up. Sorry about that, guys. I'm taking a little while. It was a little hard to get into, as you can see, clearly. All right, now I'm putting the coffee grounds inside of the little filter thingy-ma-bob that I just showed you. I wet the little filter so the coffee grounds could soak better. And I filled it all the way, the coffee grounds all the way until like the end of the, where the metal part ends. Sorry about that. I'm not making any sense right now. I hope I am. And I'm just screwing it back on to the cap right here. It got a little stuck. Sorry. I'm about to go get some water and put it into the little cup right now. Okay, there we go. I got some water. Now I'm filling it up a little more. Okay, okay. It's all good. You leave about 2 inches. Put it in slowly so it could soak in the grounds. And yeah, that's pretty much how you make cold brew. Just screw it on and you should be good to go.
So this is the next morning. Oh, that's better lighting. This is the next morning after I assembled the cold brew with the new coffee beans, coffee blend, coffee grounds, I might add, new coffee grounds from Coffee Bean. I was surprised that their coffee, I was pretty much like checked out for everything. So we're gonna go in the kitchen right now, check it out. I'm gonna have to do a voiceover because my grandparents are in there. So I'll take you along with me and we'll see if this is a good another power coffee or if this is just it's gonna be like a pumpkin spice cold brew. Healthy pumpkin spice caramel cold brew. Okay. Okay, with a little bit of cashew milk, so we'll see how it goes. Okay, that's Aurora Jones. She's gonna leave right now. Okay, there we go. All right, so let's see the cold brew that I made this morning. Alrighty. Oh man, it looks pretty good. So good. Okay, so I have to just take it.
I just have to take it out of here and stir it up, and you'll get like the legit color that it turns out to be.
Hey y'all. I might make this a voiceover, but for now, it's like this. Okay, so
this is the cold brew. How it turned out. I used a my bad. I used a light roast. Keep in mind. So we're taking out the filter. This is where I put the coffee grounds in yesterday up here. Kind of just do a little 1-2, like soak it up again. I'm trying to get all the coffee goodness. So far it smells super good, like super caramelly and whatnot. And nutty, like the coffee grounds said. Okay, I think that's enough. Alrighty, let me take it off. Okay, whatever. I'll get to the point already. But keep in mind that I haven't even tried this coffee myself. This is like a new like try for me as well. I'm gonna add in this Torani pumpkin spice sugar-free, because you know your girl is on that healthy lifestyle. When I have sugar-free stuff, I don't crave sugar. Like, my body is like, cool. Like, we didn't get sugar. We don't need the sugar. We don't crave the sugar. So when I use sugar-free stuff, I'll be like, okay, like, this is okay. But like I said, in my first power coffee video, you don't have to use what I use if it ain't your thing. You could do, look up a, like, a legit, like, healthy recipe for pumpkin spice and use real ingredients. But it's all up to you and your preferences. Whatever works for you, baby girls, baby boys, baby, and the things. Okay, okay. So this is the cup we're gonna use.
So I'm kind of making my own little crema. Also, we're starting freaking Halloween early because I'm a pumpkin. Ooh, sorry, I'm changing the lighting up in here. There we go. I'm a pumpkin spice lover, so yeah. But I kind of don't know what, like, I don't know. Like, I want to add a cup, but I feel like a cup is going to be too much. So we're kind of just going to wing it right now. This is the first time I'm going to try this coffee.
Okay, so I filled my ice all the way to the top because I just love ice. I've always loved ice.
Back to the point. So for now, I'm only going to do, like, half a cup of the cashew milk cashew milk creamer. Well, you know what? This is my little creamer. This is like my little creamer, like hack dupe for a creamer. Add the real milk of whatever creamer you like, let's say almond milk creamer, and then add like a syrup, and there you go. That's your creamer, and you can have way more of it. And it's not as calorically dense. It's way healthier, in my opinion. Okay, so we're gonna do like half a cup. Half a cup. Okay. Okay, so we're gonna add this up in her. I'm a little scared. Oh shit, okay. This is not so bad. Oh crap. Okay, and so now we're gonna do the Torani.
Holy. Oh my god, guys, it smells like pumpkin spice. That is so freaking cool, dude.
Okay, we hyped right now. Okay, we're gonna do a tablespoon of this. We're only gonna do half for now. Glug, 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 glug. That's how it sounds. Okay, we're only gonna do half. Holy crappers. You don't need no sound effects with your girl. I got you covered right here. Okay, so yeah, this is a cup right here. I'm gonna pour out the cup of cold brew. I'm so excited to try this new coffee grounds from Coffee Bean. It's a light roast. It smells caramelly and bomb.
You guys don't have to order this one either. You guys can just go and grab it. I'm sure a local Coffee Bean sells it. I got this one at Walmart, Target for sure. Okay, so oh, this is our cold brew, baby girls. Okay. Ooh wee! Okay, cup. I'm aiming for a cup because your girl needs that crack. Cup. Oh, okay, good.
Beautiful. It be looking like iced tea up in her. But it's like another cold brew recipe. I'm in shock right now because I have to hug
myself. I'm so happy and excited.
So we're gonna add in some cinnamon because I freaking love cinnamon, and this is like kind of like a healthy pumpkin spice drink. So we're gonna like, you know, nothing cray cray, like a little smidgen on top of there. We're trying it for the first time on camera. I'm a little excited, I'm a little nervous. Alright, I topped it off with some cinnamon, as you guys saw in the last clip, I'm sure. I'm a little nervous, guys. Holy freaking crap. Holy freaking.
Holy moly. Holy. That's it.
Wow, this drink literally tastes like a iced like pumpkin spice from Starbucks, and I like, what the, like, how did I do that? This was a new drink. This wasn't even meant to be anything cray cray, like, or do for anything. This is so good. Oh my god. This is so bomb! Jesus Christ, I'm so happy and excited! Ooh. One thing I might add is some vanilla sugar-free drops just to give it that extra pow. But other than that, it's super freaking good. Y'all should try it. I'm gonna upload this freaking healthy pumpkin spice right here. Like, no cap, no lie. Freaking bomb. Love, peace, and thank you for watching if you made it this far.
Isanditas on Instagram and Sandy J on YouTube. Thank you guys for watching. Thanks for the support. Yeah, try this out if you like, and it's freaking bomb. Super freaking good.
I love coffee.
Alrighty, bye y'all.